Why this?
I really didn't want to get in the situation to go to Broadway producers and get myself into the sort of situation that I have to play this if by any chance it's a success, but at least public success, that you have to really work until the audience will sort of fade out, you know. And I've been there, and I wanted kind of first of all to control the you know, the rehearsal process a little bit and decide how many weeks here and there in which countries I can perform and have certain something to say.
It's based on, In Paris is based on a short story.
It's
by a Russian...
That's right. Ivan Bunin, who was an immigrant writer, yeah, who lived in the 30s, 40s and beginning of 50s in Paris after the Civil War in Russia. He was a, you know...
And won a Nobel Prize.
He was
received
the first Russian writer who received a Prix Nobel. In early 30s, I think.
But this is adapted from a short story.
Adapted from the short story, and the title short story, In Paris. It's a story of a sort of old general, my age general, old general, who meets this young, beautiful woman in, she was waitressing in the Russian restaurant. And it's kind of classic, very simple and very poignant and tragic story about their short-lived love affair.
What made you want to do it?
Well, I felt that I kind of know a little bit about this man, you know. We grew up in knowing a bit, quite a bit about, you know, white Russians, right. You know, because it was a, you know, civil war, the Red Army, White Army, the Tsar's Army, and their defeat. And that was, those people were the best of military intelligentsia of Russia. And it was a horrific part of Russian history. Well, any civil war is a horrific part of any history of any country. And, you know, those people have been thrown out. Most of them went through the present Istanbul, Constantinople, to Central Europe, notably to Paris. And they were received in, not with the open arms by the French. It was a difficult time, and they were recovering from the First World War, you know, and the Grande Guerre, they were saying. And then suddenly there's hundreds of thousands of Russians came from abroad and needed the jobs. And people like my a character of this
Nikolai.
Play. He was luckier than others. He was writing about history of those wars for and demand of different foreign publishing houses. But most of those people that were working in the taxi as taxi drivers and bouncers in the restaurants, trying to farm, trying to do anything what they could to survive. And there's a story about this, the two lonely people, and they, mind you, left not voluntarily their homeland.
Yeah.
You know, that's the story.
Your father was a military man?
Yes.
So you drew on him as well?
A little bit, a little bit. When you're a military man, you're a military man, you know, and he was a bit, somehow when I read this short novella, I, you know, kind of images of my father from my childhood kind of came through my mind. And but let's say it's like one of my favorite actors, Max von Sydow, would play my father. Yes,
yeah.
And it is kind of helps. It kind of helps.
Yeah. Did Max von Sydow remind you of your father a bit?
No, he was much taller, much more...
Max is much taller.
Of course. Yeah. And my father's probably my size. But he was just, you know, I'm a big fan of this actor. And I remember one of the first very powerful experiences. I saw him in Bergman's, Bergman's film Seven Seals. You know, and he plays chess with the death.
Yeah,
I remember. You know, and then I had a really luck and privilege to meet him a few times. And an unforgettable actor.
Yes, he was at this table.
Extraordinary.
In the last year.
Extraordinary
and
man.
Just an extraordinary sense of someone. Who brought something,
very
brings
kind,
something very,
very
rare.
Simple and such a wonderful.
Join us online at charlierose.com.